The story of the two sons of Adam mentioned في سورة المائدة. The verses begin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, recite to them, to us, the true story of the two sons of Adam. When both of them offered a sacrifice to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of them, his sacrifice was accepted, and the other one, his sacrifice was rejected or returned to him. Now, out of envy for his brother, he ended up killing him. The first crime ever committed in the face of this earth, brothers and sisters in Islam, the cause for it was envy, al-hasad. Imagine one of the brothers envied his other brother because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his ibadah to that extent. And the first sin that we know of in details, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was disobeyed with, was also because of envy. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Iblis to bow down to Adam, what stopped Iblis from bowing down was envy. Even though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Iblis, why should you bow down? Qala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيِّ. What prevented you from prostrating to someone I created with my own hands? We know, brothers and sisters in Islam, that everything is created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the kalima, kun, except for, if you compile all the ahadith, four things Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created with his own hands. وَنَحْنُ نُثْبِتُ الْيَدَيْنِ لِلَّهِ. We affirm that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has two hands, but we don't visualize them, nor we try to figure out how they look like. And this is how we say Allah has two hands in a way that suits His Majesty, and we leave it at that. If shaitan gets to you to visualize it, say subhanallah. Whatever you visualized, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is above that, and leave it. لَمْ يَتَعَبَّدَكَ اللَّهُ بِالْكَيْفِيَةِ. Allah did not command you to figure out how Allah looks like. But you must believe in the attributes and the names of Allah, because they were conveyed to us in the Quran and the authentic hadith. One of them is this verse. What prevented you to bow down to someone I created with my own hands? So Adam was created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, two hands. Al-Jannah, Jannatul Na'im, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it with his own hands to prepare it for the believers. The pen, Al-Qalam, Al-Qadr, the pen with which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writes our aqdar. And the fourth is Al-Arsh, the throne of Allah. Four elements. Here is a creation of Allah. Allah created with his own hands. Why he didn't bow down was al-hasad. He said, I am better than him. He envied him for the status which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to Adam alayhi as-salam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, al-hasad Envy is a disease of the heart that can lead to action of the limbs, which sometimes, like in the story of Cain and Abel, that can lead you actually to do something physical with your own hands. Imagine a brother had the courage to kill his own brother because of that disease of the heart, because of envy. Sometimes it can lead you to have an evil eye just by looking, and that's where the connection between envy, which is in the heart, and the eye. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi qissat Sahl ibn Hunayf, and hear that story fi Sunan Abi Dawood, Sahihatul Isnad, it's authentically transmitted to us. A companion, Hadith Abi Umama, a companion by the name of Sahl ibn Hunayf. He was known to have a very beautiful complex, skin, very nice figure. So he was bathing one day. And you know, in the old days, you do not have shower rooms to bathe. So how they used to do it, he would keep his izar, his lower garment on, and he would wash. And he would clean underneath like you do with someone who is dead. So while he was bathing, cleaning himself, Amir ibn Rabi'ah, a companion, passed by. He looked at him and he said, "What a beautiful body." He fallen unconscious immediately. Then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam was called to the scene. And then he asked, "Who looked at him? مَن تَشُكُّونَ فِي يعني, who do you doubt giving him that eye?" They said, "Amir ibn Rabi'ah." He said, "Amir ibn Rabi'ah." He called upon him. And look what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to him, brothers and sisters in Islam. عَلَى مَا يَقْتُلُ أَحَدُكُمْ صَاحِبَهُ. Why one of you kills his companion, even though he did not extend the hand like the son of Adam? You see, the son of Adam, his hasad, his envy led him to actually grab something to kill his brother with. He used his hand. But look, the hasad can lead just to what? The burning jealousy can lead to this. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ala ma yaqtulu ahadukum sahibah." Why one of you would kill his brother? If you see something, and this is, by the way, something that you should correct, because a lot of Muslims, they say what? Salli ala al-Nabi. Salah ala al-Nabi is beautiful. Some of them will say, "Masha'Allah." Some of them actually say this and that. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. This is all wrong. When you see something that you like about your brother, about him personally, or something that he owns, you should say, "Allahumma barik fi, Allahumma barik lahu fi." That's what you should say. Salla ala al-Nabi, يقول لك صلى على النبي يا عم, يقول لك صلى على النبي. يا سيدي, الصلاة على النبي is beautiful. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه. It's beautiful. There is nothing wrong with that. But when you see something, you, and by the way, brothers and sisters in Islam, I want to tell you something. A lot of us sometimes may not intend to inflict harm upon that person, but just excessive fascination or excessive admiration of the person or what he has can mobilize the evil forces, which the jinn, to inflict harm upon that person. And you may not mean it. ولذلك one of the cures, Amr ibn Rabi'ah did not mean this, he just admired his body and he expressed that admiration, but it ended up inflicting harm upon him. Meanwhile, he should have said what? Allahumma barik fi jismi. Oh Allah, bless his body. Oh Allah, bless his car. If you see a father walking with his son, when you touch that son, say Allahumma barik fi. Because excessive admiration could lead to this, and meanwhile your intention is not that. Now just to show you the honesty of this companion Amr ibn Rabi'ah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, and this is one of the cures for evil eye, come, and he had him bathe or make wudu, one of the wording, and with the water with which he made wudu, they washed Sahl ibn Hunayf radiallahu anhum jami'ah. He stood up healthy.